Good morning. Dignitaries on the dais, Secretary Steel Sri Mohan Kumar, Sri Sushil Kumar, Additional Secretary MOEF and Chairman CPCB, Sri V.S. Prasad, Secretary General Indian Road Congress, Dr. Arvind Prasad, Director General FICCI, Sri Sudhanshu Pathak, Vice President, Tata Steel Limited, Sri Bhattacharya, ED, Operations Sale, senior government officers and senior executives from the steel industry. I can see a lot of faces from abroad also. Ladies and gentlemen, let me first of all welcome you on my own behalf and also on behalf of the FICCI's Steel Subcommittee on Slag. I am here basically to give a synopsis, basically the theme behind this seminar as to what are the problems and issues. In fact, problem exists not only in iron steel slag, it exists also in non-ferrous slag, where the problems are in fact more severe. But we have problems, as DG FICCI has already mentioned. I'll just give some technicalities first. I think you all know the slag is basically a byproduct, whether you make iron in blast furnace or any other furnace, or when you refine the hot metal in the steel making process. And it is unavoidable. Whatever is the quality of iron ore or quality of hot metal, there will be some generation of slag. The quantities of course vary. Slag is essentially a mixture of metal oxide and silicon dioxide. In a way, it is basically a silicate. There are a lot of misgivings about the basic nature of slag. All slags are not bad, or they are not hazardous. Particularly steel slag, they are inert material and they don't contain any hazardous materials. Now coming for the metallurgist, in fact, slag making is also necessary. Unless there is a slag, you can't even control the temperature properly, or you cannot avoid the minimization of the liquid metal. In fact, in metallurgical point of view, people say, if you want to make a good steel, you should go for making good slag. Now, as I told, the quantum of slag varies and purely dependent on the raw material quality. In fact, in India, our quantity or slag rate we call, it is almost double. Normally, it is 20 to 40%. That is a global range in case of iron making, and 10 to 20% in case of steel making. And we are almost double. In fact, I think you might have seen or read that GSW produced blast furnace iron at a slag rate of as high as 600 kg. So in fact, they produce more slag than iron in the blast furnace. Now, current generation of slag, BF slag is around 25 million ton, and steel slag is around 12 million ton. But with steel production going to, as you know, steel going to increase, we have aspirations to go for 300 million ton by 2025 or 2030, and 500 million ton by 2050. If that happens, you can imagine the problems associated with slag. In fact, earlier days, slag was usually dumped. There was no other options, and it used to cover a huge area. And you know, land problem. Today, it is becoming increasing problem day by day. And today, in fact, even today, I should say, there is no statutory regulations or norms for controlling the slag generations or for utilization of slag. But sometime in 2003, CPCB or Ministry of Environment and Forest, they came out with an innovative idea. They have evolved what is we call as corporate responsibility on environment protection, or CREP in short. So there is a, this is basically a voluntary initiative, and it basically the purpose is to go beyond the statutory norms. And one of the purpose is waste minimization. In fact, one of the CREP action points says that you must achieve 100% utilization of slag or recycling through recycling or reuse by 2008. There is a national task force in CPCB, of which, of course, Ministry of Steel is also a member. But the unfortunate part is that we have not been able to achieve these targets. And in fact, some time back, Ministry of Environment and Forest constituted a committee to monitor and to find out ways and means the slag in the steel industry. And in that committee, they were forcing us that you should achieve this target, but with in consulting with the industry and of course Ministry of Steel, we came out about the real issues about the slag, and we in fact took up with Ministry of Environment and Forest saying that while for iron making there are no technical issues and we can achieve these targets, probably this cannot be achieved in steel making, as this was sometime in 11-12 or so. Now, it is not that slags are not used. The situation is different in India. Worldwide, people are using 100% blast furnace slag, mostly through granulated slag in cement making, and also part of also for through air-cooled slag for other as aggregates basically. In contrast, the use of LD slag is limited. In fact, the best figures are available. What we have come to know is of 70-80%, and rest is dumped. And in India, you know, all the new blast furnaces which have come recently, they are now going for captive or in-house slag generation facilities, and they are achieving the target of 100%. But there are problems about the existing or older furnaces or older plants where there are retrofitting problems and also some other issues because of which we have not been able to achieve the 100% target. But after this modernization expansion plan which is going on in SAIL or Tata Steel or other plants, probably we'll be achieving this figure very soon. In case of SMS or LD slag particularly, this is true for electric arc furnace slag also, the utilization is very low. Utilization through the recycling in the steel plant itself is very low, about 20 to 30%. And there's limitations because of high phosphorus content in the slag. We cannot use more than some limit, otherwise the steel will have more phosphorus. Similarly, for road making or other applications, this is also not used. Of course, there are some problems and issues. And one of the technical issues is that slag contents or LD slag contents high free lime content. So if that can be addressed, probably things will totally change. Some steel plants are, in fact, it is a very good to see that some steel plants in SAIL are using the LD slags because it contains about 35% or so CaO, that is lime. So that is used as a flux material in the twin hearth furnaces, but the twin hearth furnaces are going to be phased out. So the problems will continue. GSW has recently set up a slag generation plant. Of course, this is a costly proposition, and probably the via media options available to us through this route will be limited. Globally, there are facilitating standards. This is a very important point. I think one of the main theme of this seminar is to how to facilitate slag utilization through facilitating standards. Not only standards, like we have got Indian Road Congress standards and also Indian Railway standards. There are some problems, and probably we'll be discussing that. There are some paper presentation also here. So we'll be coming to address those issues. In fact, in abroad, if you find Dr. Vijay Joshi is here, there are a lot of slag associations who address these issues. They also do carry out R&Ds to find out innovative usage of slag. Slag is considered to be a green purchasing material, green material, and there are directives in many other countries, which is not there in India, unfortunately. Like even for flyers, we have got a directive, but there's no such directive from Government of India on utilization of slag, that you have to use slag in such and such applications. You know that quarrying or mining leads to depletion of natural resources and pollution. Crushed and size coarse blast furnace slag replaces natural aggregate. This is well established across the globe. Similarly, LD slag after aging, of course, as I told you, there's a pre-lime content into it. So unless you age the LD slag, it is not fit for use in many applications. So this is being done abroad, and this can also be tried in India. But let me tell you, one thing is very clear, that India, there's a general perception, this slag is not a good material. So how can it be utilized in place of, let us say, natural aggregates like stones? But in fact, this is not the fact. The fact is just the reverse. And in fact, we have been able to, through, of course, FICCI, we have been able to convince people, and we are in the process of convincing others that, look, this is a good material, and this can be utilized in many applications and replacing the natural resources. You already know that, in fact, India is importing, sand. This is something, and Durga Shakti Nagpal case, you know. So there are issues, there are problems, and we have to really resolve all those issues. Now, in years to come, because of emphasis of the government in housing, infrastructure, road, and other things, the demand of aggregates for roads or construction is going to increase manifold. So there is an urgent need to enhance the resource base by including slag aggregates in construction and other activities. Slag products are, as I told in the beginning, they are inert, eco-friendly materials, and they can easily substitute the natural aggregates. Inclusion of slag in standards and regulations will go a long way in solving the resource problem. BIS has already initiated, it is a very good development that BIS has already initiated. I should thank FICCI for that. Of course, FICCI had led a delegation to BIS, with Director General BIS, and now the things have changed. Technical committee has already discussed this issue. We have put forward the problems, and the technical committee is very favorable to our the problems and issues, and they have only asked us to give some information to support their cause to modify or to amend the Indian standards. As I told, increasing steel production means increase in the quantity of slag generated. So we have to address this problem only by substitute. We cannot conventionally, whatever you are using, to go beyond that manifold, we have to utilize the slags in place of aggregates. Now, this requires, of course, the very close association and helping hand from the steel producers. I should admit here that I don't find a lot of people or a lot of all the steel industries to come forward and help FICCI in the matter. Only few people or few companies are coming forward and taking up the matter here and there. So I request the steel industry on behalf of Ministry of Steel and also on behalf of the FICCI Slag Committee to really come forward and let us address this problem jointly. Thank you very much.